Hi, I'm Mike College, President of Ipsos Reid Public Affairs in Canada. I have a great job. I get to work with a lot of interesting researchers, a lot of interesting clients, but essentially I get to poke at the issues, have conversation with Canadians, and fulfill my curiosity and help our clients understand the world around them. I want to talk today about how technology changes the music industry and how I see that same technology and its advancement changing politics and public policy today. If you go back to 1981, the very first music video played on MTV was Video Killed the Radio Star. And I don't think I need to go into the stats on how video and the way we consume music through television, whether it was Much Music or MTV, changed the way we looked at music, and it changed the industry completely. By 1999, Napster came along. Napster and other peer-to-peer file sharing changed fundamentally the music industry forever. 2002, David Bowie said, "I don't think I'll even need a record label in the future." And that's proven to be very true. Over the last decade, record labels have had less influence on the entire process of music. And I think the same thing's happening from here forward with public policy, political organizations, and our government institutions. What we're going to see is less and less reliance on political parties. So look at political parties as if they were record labels. Political parties were designed or, you know, came into play because they were there to aggregate public opinion, aggregate the views of the public, and bring them forward, and then articulate those as policies that could appeal to the masses. If they did well, they got elected. Record labels did the same thing. They were there to aggregate the views and the musical tastes of a society or a group of individuals, bring them together, control the musical process, and if they did well and put out products that people could buy, they got great record sales. Over the last decade or so, record sales have fallen about 50% in North America. And the same things happen on the political side. Fewer and fewer people are voting, fewer and fewer people are engaged in the party structures, fewer and fewer people are involved in politics, at least in a traditional sense. All of our research shows that they're engaged more and more online. They're having their say with each other, they're talking about issues that are important to them, and they're talking to each other, which is really interesting. I think going forward, you'll see a very different breed of politician. You'll get to see maybe a Prime Minister Drake, maybe a President Beyonce, but it'll be someone who understands the media. And I don't mean the traditional media, someone who understands social media, they understand the distribution mechanisms, they understand how to tap into it, to understand what people want. And I don't think we're seeing that right now.